I'm in my car, I'm driving far, drive time.
Oh, that sun looked pretty nice, didn't it? Poking through the trees. It looked nice on the video camera. I had a nice little time watching that. This is Drive Time. My name's Vernon Howe. It's episode D. Episode 8D. Season 3. 6:48 Eastern Standard Time, PM. Central New Jersey. It's a beautiful evening. 70s. Mid-70s. Not humid. Unseasonably dehumid. Non-humid. Sorry, I can't think straight. I just, the Stairmaster kicked my ass again. I was actually going to try and do more. I was trying to do 200. I crapped out at 170. Just felt, I've also like been eating better, so I don't think I'm taking in as many carbs. Maybe protein. Just whatever, some sort of general lack of overall energy. I just felt exhausted, but in a good way. 78. 78 degrees, I'm just checking the weather now. Seems cooler than that. Oh. 0% chance of rain. Yeah, it's rapidly getting it down into the high 60s tonight. So that'd be nice. Nice night. Yeah. I had a good day overall today, man. I can't complain about my day. I got a lot of work done. I just barreled through the day. I said to the day, hi day. Name is Vern here. Hope you're ready to submit. Submit to the big boy. What? Yeah, boy. But I'm subdued, and just the air and coming in the windows is feeling nice. My car doesn't really have AC to speak of, so it's a fresh air or bust. And I'm waiting for the 95 and humid days. But hey, no, I'm not. That's not a good attitude to have. I just put my seatbelt on. Notoriously bad seatbelt putter on her. I also have a habit of taking it off like a mile before I get home. Like that's gonna save time if I take it off. It's not gonna save time. It's not gonna save my life. Save my life, you leave it on. That's what you have to do. Jeez Louise, my foot's feeling better. 32 years old, you know? It's like, but I always like to look at the bright side. I mean, it's funny, you can look at it, oh, I'm gonna live to 90 something, then you're like, I'm a third of the way through, but then you hit 40 and you're like, fuck, I'm probably only gonna be live to 80 at best, so I'm a halfway through. And the difference between that is like the 8 years right now is like between looking at life being a third over and being half over. You know, best case scenarios in both situations. Well, what do? You know, all you can really do is have, you know, and this is me talking, and I don't speak for anybody, but I think if you have a plan for what you want to accomplish in a day, and even if you can come even within 75 to 80% of that goal of completing that, you know, if you're in the B range, 80%, fuck, man, you're doing pretty well. And, you know, it's good to, you know, give yourself a lot. I'm talking getting B's when you have, let's just keep this metaphor going. It's just I can't get out. So, you know, you have a full course load. Right? Another funny thing that happened to me today was, So my food Twitter, which is really turning out to be just a beautiful thing, because I'm garnering some good responses, I feel. It's really offering me a chance to kind of F with some people, and I don't mean to, I feel bad effing with the people who have to control these company Twitter feeds, but, you know, if they bring on themselves and just kind of mindlessly reply to people who mention their brand, you know, the same people I went down the rabbit hole with the other day, the Zone Bar people, I was talking about shrimp scampi flavored breakfast bars. Zone Perfect is the company's name. They make like chocolatey protein bar, which is what I eat every day on the weekdays. Monday through Friday, it's pretty much my breakfast every day. It's that, coffee, and like a lot of water and some juice. That's, I'm like unshakable. That's what I eat. It's just easy. I just don't think about it, and I can just start my day and off, and it's like tasty. It's a good breakfast. But anyway, I don't know if I talk about this one or the Chobani one only on this show. But they tweeted back to me again. What started it last time was when I had a different flavor. They came back at me and said, "Holy shit, hold on a second. Hello? Sorry. I have this number keeps calling me from Maryland. Anyway, the Zone Perfect people at replied to the same thing that started this asinine conversation we just had the day before. I'm not interested. Don't call me again. This number from Maryland, Oakland, Maryland, has called me 5 times a day for the last week and a half. And I've tried to pick up and just, because I don't know how you just saw, how do you stop them from calling you? Nothing happens. Like, that was the first time I actually got a voice recording. Usually it was just like a beep sound. Just fucking stupid. What the hell? So that's that for today.